is our make and launch project. I'm Stefan, this is Kennedy, this is Bailey, and this is Anna.
So our project is about taking a vacant lot and transforming it into something that was useful for the community that would provide a positive benefit. We use innovation and decision-making skills to come up with the best use for this vacant lot that would and figure out how it would benefit the specific community that we're serving here by Oldham County High School and the Government Center. So our lot ideas was Kennedy had the skate park idea, I had an outdoor photo studio idea, Savannah had apartments, and Anna had a coffee shop.
Starting off with the skate park, a skate park would be great because it provides a way for our younger generations to stay active, if it's biking, skateboarding, or scootering, and the skate park can also host events and competitions to bring people into our community.
So with the outdoor photo studio, I thought it was somewhere for like people to take pictures using the nature, being that it's like mainly city throughout here. And using nature photography is just really like aesthetically pleasing, and with the different flowers that can be used, it can also help
So my idea were apartments and they would generate a lot of revenue. Also it would bring new people to our community, but the lot size is not big enough and it would cost a lot of money to build them.
My idea was coffee shop and I thought that it was a good place. It should go get coffee in the morning to wake up. If they would just go get coffee, they should go get some. It would be easily accessible to school. And a place for students to hang out and study after school, because I know that like having the incentive of like going to a cute coffee shop or getting coffee while you're studying could have a positive impact on them wanting to do more and things like that. It could also fundraise for the school, because I know a lot of schools have like the class representatives of class governments and stuff that need to host fundraisers and stuff for their schools so they can do different things. And this would be a good spot that could host all of those different things, since there are a lot of schools around here. And then I could just host different events for the community, like go get a coffee for half off on this day to support this day. It's not school related.
So this is our decision matrix, which is based on 5 components: location, cost, lot size, revenue projection, hours of operation, which are to a total of 21 points. The coffee shop won with 15 points because of the revenue projections of hours of operation. That's why it is our main idea, and we stick with the coffee shop.
So the coffee shop is going to be a place to hang out, a place for students to study and get homework done, and then just a location for all ages to come enjoy some coffee and some good time in community.
So here's our business plan. Starting off with identity, a coffee shop that makes shifts that are caffeinated for all people of ages. That was another component. A lot of the other ones were very limited to younger generations, but a coffee shop can include everyone in the community. Our problem are some people are looking for places to get their morning coffee before school and easier access to location. That leads us into our competition. Our major competition is Starbucks, and there are 2 locations in Crestwood and in Kroger, but there are none near here. Our solution would be having a coffee shop in a central location for teenagers to order for them and have the drinks that they want. And our target market is teenagers and teachers, because that's who is surrounding the coffee shop.
So we thought like a good revenue stream was just like be inside the coffee shop, because it's like a little harder to order online with everyone around. Marketing activities that we would have is promotions and like discounts on drinks for some days, if there's like specific days of the weeks. One of the major expenses is the money for the syrups, for the drinks to be flavored, money for coffee beans and all the machines needed to make the drinks, and then storage space for all the products. Some of the team and key roles were that we were all the owners, but like we will each have individual roles that include accounting, marketing, managing, and many more. And then as the shop grows, we plan to add more products or add more promotions. So our lessons learned were, all ideas work together, but some have a better outcome. So like, we all had good ideas, but some just fit the context of the community and the size of the lot and just the space better. Working together creates ideas, so we all had good ideas, but working together to figure out, okay, which is the best one for our specific situation really helped us, one, get to know each other better and just get to work on communicating. And then how to listen and incorporate all ideas. So we had to think and, so the coffee shop was my idea, but we all had different ideas on how the presentation would look, what exactly the coffee shop would be like, and just different simple things like that. And something we want to change, we're just making decisions quick.
quicker. It was kind of a slow process of, okay, what do we want to do? Okay, now we know what we want to do.
Do you guys have any questions?
Okay, I'm going to show you what I'm talking about.
So even though our target market is teenagers and teachers right now, there will be everyone in the community can have access to the coffee shop. These are just the people that we think will start coming more often and in like the first six months to a year. But as word gets out and more people start noticing and seeing our marketing, more people will come.
Why did you choose a coffee shop instead of a skate park?
We chose a coffee shop instead of a skate park, one because the coffee shop caters to different more demographics than just the youth and teenagers that we mostly use the skate park, and the lot size. Like someone pointed out with the apartments, the lot size isn't huge, and the skate park would require a lot of space, so the coffee shop could be one building that could fit inside that lot size.
One more question.
Because you chose a coffee shop and you mentioned morning coffee, is your coffee shop going to strictly sell coffee, or is it also going to be more of a breakfast bar as well?
I think it'll be like more of a breakfast bar too, because some kids like don't either have time to get breakfast at their house if they drive to school, and like it would be open all day, because like sometimes teachers may want to get out and like get something to drink and just have like a break from school in the school environment.
All right, give them a hand. Thank you.